هيا على الفلاح.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In the name of Allah, most gracious, most merciful. Today we will be speaking about parents and their role and the importance of parents in our lives. Firstly, we need to know that the Almighty has created us. In order to make us, He has chosen a specific path. None of us have applied to ask for the type of parents we have been given. And none of our parents have applied to ask for the child that they have been bestowed with. This is the sole decision of the Supreme Maker. And for this reason, He instructs us in the Quran very clearly, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Your Lord has decided and dictated, or He has passed the law that you shall worship none but Him, and you will be dutiful unto your parents, or you will be kind to your parents. The reason He speaks of kindness to parents is because He chose them. He chose them as a test for them as well as for us. So every one of us has parents, and our parents are a test for us, and we are a test for them. This is why it is important for us to be kind to them. Let us start from the very beginning. When we were young, had we not been looked after by our mothers, we probably would have died. Or perhaps, if the Almighty willed, we may have been looked after by someone else in the absence of our mothers or our parents. However it has been, we need to realize the blessing of the Almighty, because when a child is very small, they need another human being to look after them in order to survive. And this is a miracle. Imagine, a child cannot survive on its own. Here we are talking of babies and infants. They will not survive on their own without the assistance of someone else who is standing with them, who can feed them, who can clothe them, who can help them do whatever they have to, and so on. For that, we owe. What do we owe? We owe in return the respect to our parents and to those who looked after us, to those who have brought us up. We owe them absolutely much, and we definitely need to respect them. However, this respect, which is extremely important, we need to realize and understand that the Almighty has dictated it, and it is not up to us to say, I'm not going to be good to my parents, so we disobey them and we don't want to listen to them. We need to listen to their advice. It is the duty of a parent to advise the child, to guide the child, to give them an upbringing, to provide education for them, to assist them in whatever way possible. It is the duty of the parent to feed the child, to give accommodation to the child. It is the duty of the parent to speak kindly to the child. Imagine, many people speak about how important it is for the child to speak kindly to the parent, but they forget that it is also the duty of the parent to speak kindly to the child, to say words that will be good, to abstain from foul language, to abstain from anger and such bad habits in the presence of the child that may brush off onto the child. So yes, it is important for the parents to have a good relation with the children, and for the children to have a good relation with their parents. This having been said, mostly on the globe we find one major problem, and that is parents complain about how undutiful their children are, especially after a certain age. Once they become teenage, once they grow slightly older, when the decision of marriage comes into play, you find that many parents complain, you know, my son, my daughter, and so on. Let us speak about that for a few minutes. What we need to realize is, yes, we will obey the instruction of our parents on condition that those instructions do not negate what the Almighty has instructed us with. So if, for example, we know that alcohol is prohibited, when your father tells you, here is the money, go and buy me some alcohol, you will say, no, my dad, the Almighty overrides and overrules your instruction. He has instructed me not to do that. You are instructing me to do that. Because the two are clashing, the Almighty overrides, I will not do this. Amazing. This is the law of the Almighty. And this, from this we learn that the bad qualities that the parents have should never be allowed to brush off onto the children. Sometimes the children develop better character and conduct than their own parents. That is a gift of the Almighty. Sometimes the children's education is far higher and their understanding is far greater than that of their own parents. And this is also a gift of the Almighty. But what we do need to know is, generally, wherever possible, we should be listening to them, obeying their instruction in that which is reasonable. When we say that which is reasonable, what we do mean is, if they instruct us to do something silly, or they interfere in certain decisions that the Almighty has given us the sole right to, then sometimes we can excuse them in a very polite way. Let me give an example. When it comes to a young girl, yes, the parents have a say in advising her and encouraging her who to marry and who and how to marry and so on. However, they cannot force her to marry a particular person. So if a parent decides to force the daughter that you will only marry this person, they are wrong. That's a mistake. It's more culture than religion. To be honest with you, if that girl has to say, look, my dear father, I will not be able to obey this instruction of yours, she is not at all to be blamed, nor is she sinful, because the father is outside his rights. He is beyond the rights. He is not within his rights when he instructs his daughter. Sadly, you have certain people who are ignorant because they owe money to someone, because they feel obliged to someone, because someone has helped them, because a person is a cousin or related and they don't want to break the relation of the family. They tell their daughter, no, you have to marry. You have to say yes to this proposal. In that particular case, we excuse the parents. And my address here is to the parents. Please be understanding. Try and understand that your maker is definitely going to question you. Remember, the children you have are a trust unto you, given by the Almighty. You cannot step the boundaries that the Almighty has given you in order to achieve something you want when it is the right of an individual human being to make a choice. We ask the Almighty to grant us goodness. What we also need to know is, where the child is making a very dangerous choice, it is our duty to guide them. It is our duty to tell them. It is our duty to try our best to explain to them. And we need to realize we're living in what is known as a free world today, especially in countries where we are in a minority. We're living in a free world where the children can choose secularly whatever they want to do. Although we as parents would like them to choose things according to our liking, we need to work very hard. Rather than command your child, convince them. Talk to them, speak to them, explain to them, discuss, listen to the proof and evidence they have and you present yours. Listen to the logic they have and you present yours. And then what happens is, allow those who have the better logic, the better evidence, the stronger opinion to win, rather than imposing your view at all times. Because if we were to impose our views on our children, as soon as we close the door, they will do something else. They will feel like a free bird flying. This is common sense. It's happening to so many people. Some people force their children to do something. As soon as the door closes, they are out. So we ask the Almighty to make us not from amongst those who do not realize this type of relation that is meant to be between the parents and the children. I'd like to close by saying, although this topic is very large, what we've discussed today, the importance of obeying your parents within reasonable limits and the importance of parents being good and role models to their children, this is very important. Because if a parent is not a role model to his or her own children, how do you expect that child to develop and to become better? You have a parent, for example, who smokes like a chimney and they are telling their children, do not smoke. That is very foolish. Although they know that it's bad, they will have to sit and explain and make an effort to give up that habit so your children can see that you really believe it's a bad habit. The same applies. There are a lot of parents who are busy having affairs and yet they are worried about their children. My son must not do this. My daughter must not do that. But give up your own bad habit to start with and then you will be blessed. So we ask the Almighty to grant us a deeper understanding. I know I have given examples off the cuff. I normally like to give relevant examples. We call it pressing the red button. Because we don't want to give examples of that which does not happen in society. Rather give the example of something real so that we can learn from it. I hope and I pray we've said a few words that can encourage us to have the best relation. Rather than being a parent and child relation, it nowadays needs to be more of a friend relation where we can relate. When they have a problem, the first person they think of is dad, the first person they think of is mum, rather than going to the friend or to someone else who is outside the home to get advice which might be wrong and detrimental. We need to open this relation and we need to have a better relation with our own children. Until we meet again, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Every single person that will benefit from this particular platform, even in the smallest way, the full reward will go to every single person who's donated even the smallest amount. So don't think that I cannot do it and go to the donate section and follow it up and try and give a donation that might be a small amount but regular. And even if it's just a one-off amount, if that's what you can manage, alhamdulillah.